watching our real estate show, the show that gets you India's best property deals. And of course, this is our mega Diwali special, where we are getting you the hottest deals in retail, in homes, and of course, in office space. Well, of course, there's no denying the fact that the last 1 year was rather turbulent for the realty sector. And as the sector emerges out of the downturn, there are learnings and lessons to be learned.
Hello and welcome to this edition of Meet Your Developer. This week I have Sushil Mantri, Chairman of Mantri Developers. So thank you so much for talking to us.
Nice to meet you.
If I can begin by asking you about the overall sentiment in the southern market where most of your developing is happening.
Right.
Take us through what the sentiment has been over the past 6 months and what your outlook going forward.
See, I think the being Hyderabad, Chennai and Bangalore, these towns are more dependent on IT because the major crowd is IT here. So definitely sentiments are last year were a little affected in these towns because more employees are losing the jobs and salaries getting reduced and so many things happening. But we are seeing now last 6 months, say from April onward, things have really changed. And after the May when the central elections took place, now sentiments are quite positive and people are now really positive on the overall. And if you see now the salary cuts are not happening, job reductions are not happening. I think overall scenario is in positive area now.
For Mantri itself, how's the sales numbers been over the last quarter? Take us through the kind of percentage of growth, at least whatever marginal growth that you've seen in the last quarter.
Mm-hmm. If you see October to December, the sale were very, very minimum. You can almost say like nil. And then Jan to March was also reasonable growth was there. But March, April onward, we are seeing a very good surge. And today we are hitting all the numbers which we are touching in the peak time numbers.
Okay.
I think the sales have really picked up very well now.
Bangalore, Chennai, Hyderabad have a huge IT population. What's been the sentiment there in that clientele itself? Because it's pretty much over 50% of your overall business.
Yeah, IT, see, IT earlier was about 60% of our total volume of business. But today that is fallen about to 40%. Many non-IT people are coming forward. Now, if you take a Bangalore, like where a population of about 6 million is there, IT crowd is about 3 lakh people, but there are 57 lakh people who are non-IT people. And we are getting a good chunk of business from these people.
It's been tough times the past 1 year itself. What has been Mantri's strategy to stay afloat during these tough times?
No, see, yes, it was a tough time for all the developers. But what happened, like our company is not over-borrowed. And because of that, I think we don't have the pressure of interest and repayments. Where the borrowings are very high, I think the problem is large. And second thing, what happened from 2007 July, we really stopped buying new properties because we felt the prices have really gone up and it is unaffordable. And because of that, I think we were ready with the cash and that cash flow has really helped us today to carry on in this slowdown time.
Okay. Also, during that period, there was a lot of delayed projects that we heard from the market. What is the status of your upcoming projects? Are they all on time? Are you facing any delays in any of these projects?
No, I think so far we were able to sell through because as I told you, we didn't bought the properties in last 1.5 years. We were having the cash flow available and that we have utilized for the completion of these projects. And that has really saved our name. But there are vacancy rate is little larger here because otherwise we were not having any unsold flats available. But we are carrying some small inventory with us now.
Also, your larger investment plans, I was reading at an earlier interview that you talked about 1,000 crores over the next few years that you're planning to invest. Is that also going slow or are you still going
ahead
with that?
Yeah, that's going slow because that is more of a township project. And you know, earlier people were ready to go for 20, 25 kilometer away for buying a home.
Sure.
Today, everybody want home very near to the city. And that all bullish calculations, we also made it realistic now. And this township project, we are going more on a slower side. In fact, we are more focusing on master plan and city area development, where 1 or 2 million square feet projects, we are more focusing because they can be completed faster and cash flow also can be generated much quicker.
Okay. Since you have such ambitious plans in all spheres of retail, commercial, as well as residential, any fundraising plans, IPO, what is the plan to raise all these funds?
No, immediately we are not planning to go for the IPO because we already have our investment partner Morgan Stanley with us in parent company.
Sure.
And the banks are supporting quite a lot. I think because our leveraging is quite low in the company. And we feel that time being, we don't want to go immediately for IPO, but maybe after 2 years, we can look for the IPO too, for our growth plan.
Okay. Also, your partner, Morgan Stanley, what's been the relationship so far? I mean, are they happy with the way the real estate market in India, especially in the southern market for you, has shaped up?
No, I would say, I think there is no reason Morgan Stanley to be upset in India, because if you really see, ours is the first investment in India, which was done in 2006.
Sure.
And their majority of the investments were done in 2006 and 7. That time, markets were quite at a low price, and all their companies are doing very well.
So would you like them to increase their stake? They have a minority stake right now. Would you like them to, are you in talks to increase their stake, or what is the status of that?
No, we are talking with them for a SPV level kind of investments. But time being, actually, because our majority of the properties are fully paid properties where investment is not required. And that is the reason I think they are interested. But time being, we feel that there is no immediate requirement of a private equity investment in Mantri Developers.
Okay. Also, the important question about the IT SEZ, there's something coming up in Hyderabad as well.
Right.
What is your status of that project? Are you planning to take that to Pune as well as one of the areas that you're looking at?
No, IT SEZ in Hyderabad, we are going slower on that side, because the demand for IT is really came down, because nobody is going for expansion. And few people they have removed now, that vacancies they have to fill first actually. And unless the new business get generated from US, I think the expansions will not happen in immediate, maybe in next 6 months time.
Okay. Also, you've talked about the future of real estate in India being in the affordable housing segment. Mantri has traditionally been a premium builder. When do we see 18, 15 lakh homes from Mantri itself?
We made a study. I think below 20 lakh going for us is difficult, because we, as a Mantri, we have certain quality standards, and we don't want to compromise on that area. We have our own set of specifications, because which we feel in a long run, you know, it will be minimum requirement for any human being to live in the apartment. We don't want to compromise on that area.
Okay.
We'll be shortly launching about in by March or April our project, where the flats are about 20 lakh rupees, between 20 to 40 lakh rupees.
Okay.
And that will be having all the facilities like any other project of Mantri. But the sizes are smaller, but we don't want to compromise on the specifications and quality.
Also, the big question about prices, where residential prices, property prices are headed. Are we looking at a stage where developers are going to increase it substantially, or should, you know, home buyers, prospective home buyers, go in for the investment now?
I personally feel presently developers will not increase the prices. But we are in a different industry where when prices start going up, people, the demand goes up. And maybe I think I have heard a lot of talks on prices increase, but I think it's like more of an eyewash, but that is helping us to get the demand increase. And I don't think there is any reason immediately to increase the prices.
Okay.
Yeah.
So there you heard it from Sushil Mantri. Clearly he believes that the property prices are pretty much going to stay where they are right now, because developers are not interested in moving their prices anywhere northward as of now. But he's extremely bullish about the company's future plans. He believes that the real estate market in India is here for the long run, and Mantri is really going to be part of that growth industry.
Of course, we'd love to take your queries with your developers, so just send us your questions on realestate@utvnet.com. Homes for less than 25 lakh rupees near Delhi and Mumbai. More on that in just a